Hi there, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. Welcome to our website. Hey, I've got a really nice coach that we just got in that I wanted to tell you about. I'm going to walk you around and show you a few features on this Navion. This is a 2014 Navion IQ. It's called a 24V model, so we'll get a chance to go inside here in just a minute. You can see the layout of the floor plan. It's really pretty unique, real popular layout. This is a Winnebago product. The task is built at the Winnebago factory. Good quality throughout, inside and out. You can see has a nice full body paint scheme on here. The IQ model has a little bit more of a low profile than some of the other Class C's you might find. Notice how the front has a less of an overhang, so it's less wind resistant. So, and it's not quite as tall overall as some of the other coaches that you might find that are built on this format. Now this is a built on a Sprinter, Mercedes Sprinter chassis, so it has a six-cylinder Mercedes diesel engine, good fuel economy. You know, they're really built well, very popular motorhomes actually. As we look around here, we're losing our microphone, you can see that it's got a nice big awning, which is electric too, by the way, so that awning comes in and out with the push of a button. Again, you know, full body paint, has a nice appealing look to it. That's storage in here, nice big storage compartment. This is kind of nice too. You can actually run a cord back up and through here and plug in. It has an inverter here also that we can see when we go inside. The advantage of that is if you're dry camping, you'd be able to run some of your appliances off of that. Draw off your battery power if you're not plugged in. You do have a generator too, so that'll supply power to you if you're not someplace where you're able to plug in. It's got a 3600 LP generator, so got plenty of power. Nice quiet generator. Take a look at the storage back in here. It's got a nice large storage compartment. Notice how everything's finished out nice. Even the storage areas are finished nicely. They actually do their own plastics, so that's made at their factory. Probably somewhere between 80 and 85% of this motorhome is built, apart from the chassis, the motorhome part, the house part, is built by Winnebago. They don't just buy parts from somebody and put them together. They're a true manufacturer, so they build their parts and they assemble their parts. And everything's labeled. So as we go inside, we can see the same. If we open up cabinet doors, we'll see that each, you know, almost every part on here is going to have a little label. So if we ever needed to replace this, we could call the Winnebago factory. They'd probably have it on hand, but even if they didn't, they know exactly what they can manufacture because they built it. And so probably, I don't know if any manufacturer that has a better system for replacing parts for your motorhome. They use a, this one has a ladder to get up on top. I was going to say they use a one-piece fiberglass roof, so it's not a lot of seams up there, less things to worry about maintenance-wise. It's very durable, better than a rubber roof. You don't have the issues that you do with chalking and that type of thing with the fiberglass roof. Just have to make sure your seals around your air conditioning and vents and that type of thing are going to be kept up to date, and so you don't have a lot of cracking and drying out. Plug, a setup for towing. It does have a tow package on it. I think you mentioned it does have a backup monitor. There's your freshwater hookups and your power cord. Has 30 amp powers. Dump valve right there. So there's where you hook up your sewer, your propane fill system access is right there, and you can see that you have a gray water tank right there. I like this too. This is a nice feature. They've got the sensors on the outside rather than on the inside of your tank. So the advantage of that is you're going to have less problems with corrosion. You know, sometimes these sensors on the inside over a period of time, you get bad readings because they either get corroded or maybe, especially like a black tank, it might have toilet paper hanging on it or something, that's not going to give you a true reading. So having them on the outside, you don't have that issue. Again, more storage. Even has a little spot there where you could put in your sewer hose. Mercedes technology, we'll talk about that a little bit more once we go inside in the cockpit area. Nice little step going in. It's really a good looking motorhome. You know, if your idea is to get something that you can maneuver easily, get out on the road, have the conveniences, but not worry about where you're going to land with a land yacht, this is a good opportunity for somebody. And the chassis are pretty phenomenal. It does have controls right here next to the step well. As you're coming in, you can see you have disconnect switch right there. The awning, we talked about that. That's the power awning. Controls are right there. Your lighting's right here. Everything's pretty easy to get to as you first come into the coach. Now these front seats are going to spin around as well, so I can rotate these seats facing the back so you can use them as part of your furniture. But notice a nice clean cockpit. This one's going to have let's say the backup monitor, and this is an automatic transmission, but it does have the slapstick feature, which if you're familiar with that, it allows you to actually shift up and down by yourself if you want to, just by moving the gear shift over. So if I'm going, let's say I'm climbing a hill and I want to drop down a gear, I'm in drive, I can just push this over one way or the other, and it'll either go up a gear or down a gear, so I can control maybe the amount of torque I have, or the RPMs on my driving. So it's a little bit more like driving in a manual transmission, where you can shift when you want it to shift. But if you don't want to mess with it, you don't have to. It does all the work for you. It's just one feature that gives you a little more control as a driver. It does have tilt wheel, so I can adjust the steering wheel, cruise control switch. You know, my understanding is that these cruise controls that Mercedes-Benz use are so precise that you can actually change your speeds by half mile increments. So at least that's what I've been told. I have no reason to doubt that. I know Mercedes is, they got things dialed in. When they do it, they generally do it right. They're really known for safety and engineering. So speaking of safety, I think it's really important to let you know too, this coach has some safety features you're not going to have on other motorhomes. And that is, it has a yaw sensors, this ASR feature right here, which has an on and off switch, so I can actually disable it. But when it's on, what it's going to do is it's going to let the coach know that if I'm driving, maybe I'm going around a corner a little bit too fast and I'm starting to go into a little bit of a slide, by the time I figure out that I'm not that I'm in a little bit of a trouble, it's already made corrections. It's already, the yaw sensors, the computer sensors, can determine that my steering wheel says I want to go here, but I'm going outside of that arc. So it'll use power to my wheels and brakes to my wheels, since this has four-wheel anti-lock brakes, that will help bring me back into line with where I'm intending to go. So you know, one of those features that actually helps you prevent accidents. It's nice to have features that help you when there is an accident, but even better if you can find something that'll help you prevent an accident. And this is one of those motorhomes that's able to do that. Again, Mercedes, that's always been one, really kind of their premier focus is on safety and, you know, longevity. They build stuff to last. It also has airbags up front here too, so you do have a driver's side and a passenger side airbag, so there are other safety features involved, which is, you know, on a lot of motorhomes you won't have that. So I think that's really a good point on this particular coach. You know, and we get, with this six-cylinder diesel, people tell us they get really good mileage, so it's very, very pleasing. I guess we hear about 15, 16 miles to the gallon. Check this out. You've got shades already built in, so at nighttime you want to button her up for the evening. I can just pull the shades over here. Everything's already in here. All I have to do is just slide them open and they'll snap into place. These two, actually this side and this side, are going to come together. I can just snap them into place. Just that easy. I'm ready to turn in for the evening. I don't have to worry about, you know, pulling curtains around or whatever, or finding, you know, some way to give myself some privacy. This skylight too, by the way, adds quite a bit of light, natural light, but I can also close this off too. So I can button this whole thing up very easily. We're not lacking for remotes, as you can see. It's got a remote for every occasion, apparently. It has a little curtain here. It looks like that's I'd have to find out where that goes. Actually, I'm not even really sure on that. More storage up in here. So he's got speakers here. This also is a really nice feature. So this one is going to allow me to open this up. So I want to let in a little bit of air. I can open that vent up. So electrically, there should be another switch over here down right where I'm going into the coach, so I don't have to reach up here and get that. I've got a screen there that I can block some of the sun, or if I want to block it all out, I can. If you're in you're in the area where you just got, or maybe you're just in for the evening and you got lights out there, you don't want to have light coming in, or maybe you sleep in late, you don't want the sunlight coming in, close it off. You got a way to do that, but it does let in a lot of natural light. Good amount of storage. Got MCD shades that are real easy to operate. You got night shades and day shades. This actually makes into another bed, so you have another sleeper. This will fold out, make into another bed. So you have that bed. Also have the bed in the back, which we're going to look at here in a second. But I just wanted to show you some more things in the kitchen. You got lots of cabinets. Again, you know, we talked about the fact that everything's labeled. All your inside cabinet doors are labeled. Notice the nice finish, has a European style to it, to put the hidden hinges. Nice stainless steel sinks. You got two sinks. This is sink covers. There's two burner stovetop. Got a nice plug-in right there, so you got power you can access. Got a little TV right there, even has another 110 outlet right there. Another label. Okay, just everything in here should be labeled for the most part. Even these cabinet drawers, if you pull them out and move them upside down, you'd see there's a label probably underneath here. You got lots of drawers. Looks like this is a good spot to put pots and pans. It's going to have freezer, refrigerator down below. So you got a two-door refrigerator separate, freezer separate from the refrigerator. I like the fact that your controls are right here in a central location, so I can come over here and I can check. I can turn on my water pump, hot water heater. I can see how I'm doing with my water levels, my tank levels, and I can start my generator from right here also. Holding tank heater. So this has a heater for my holding tank. So if I'm out in pretty cold weather and I'm a little concerned that maybe it's going to get too cold and something might freeze up on my holding tanks, I can turn that on and help keep that heat to that, so I don't have to worry about it freezing up. And then you have your LP on and off there, so you can actually shut off your LP, so you're not going to have to worry about LP going in or out. A slide controls right here, and it has a master switch too, on and off switch. So if you actually didn't want someone to play with the slide out, you can pull the key out. It has an inverter too. I think I mentioned when we were outside that it has a 1,000-watt inverter, so that makes it nice. You can draw from your batteries and use something to probably operate your TV, possibly your microwave. It's got a nice little convection microwave, so you have heat and convection in this one. Looks like this will do both. Bathroom is private bath, so you have your shower, sink, toilet all in one. A lot of people like that. That way everything's all in one area. Nothing separate. You see you've got some storage, additional storage in there too. Now the bedroom area, this is a fairly new floor plan, this V model, which gives you some versatility. As it's set up right now, I've got twin beds. So I've got two small beds, twin beds, I guess, would be, you know, fine for two people to sleep back in here and have some room in between. Now, if I want to make this into one bed, all I have to do is slide this out. Maybe you're out in the weather and it's not really nice and it's a kind of a cold night and you thought, you know, it'd be kind of nice to snuggle. So there you go. You got one big bed. You got, you know, plenty of room to move around in there. Quite convenient, easy to set up too. I mean, it's not a lot of fuss. You just have to slide this in. And then I like the fact you've got some drawers in here also. And the heat, you have a heat duct right back in here also. Notice all the storage back here. Tons of storage. They really utilize the space well. The little shelf up in here on both sides with 110 outlets. So that's a lot of people use CPAPs now. You can actually, it's probably enough room in there where you could put your CPAP in there and plug it in. Air conditioning's fully ducted, so you got air conditioning ducts going all the way through the ceiling. Heat's ducted, it's got them down below. Even has it's another AM/FM CD player right here. This will actually looks like it's set up to play DVDs also, so you can slide a movie in there. TV's right back in here, so you have a bedroom TV also. And this thing's like new. It's only got like 6,500 miles. 2014 Navion IQ, 24 IQ. Great motorhome, quality throughout. Boy, this could be a good opportunity for you, and if you're looking for a small motorhome that's economical and fun to drive. So give me a call. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. Just ask for Jim. And again, it's Jim Beckler here at the RV Corral. Thanks.